the U.S. Caribbean Energy Summit can be considered a success and with the potential for many areas of cooperation between Caribbean states and the U.S. It was very heartening to see that the Vice President and his team, including the Secretary of Energy, as well as representatives from the Department of State, took their time to go through many of the issues of concern to the region. One of the areas that was dealt with extensively was the area of climate change, and there was a very frank and open discussion as to the U.S. roles and U.S. involvement in ensuring that in Paris this year that we have an agreement that will further the world's aspiration in terms of ensuring that commitments are made and action taken to deal with the climate crisis. It was reassuring that the U.S. itself was ready to take some bold steps, as we've seen demonstrated with its agreement with China and more recently with President Obama's engagement in India. But certainly the Caribbean leaders and Caribbean states pressed the U.S. to ensure that its commitments were solid, and recognizing too that Caribbean states, small island developing states, had unique exposure, unique risk, and required support both in terms of adaptation as well as mitigation. And there was commitment from the U.S. to work both at the multilateral level as well as the bilateral level to pursue those. And so there was that frank and open discussion with Guyana, certainly. Our team led by the Prime Minister raised the issue in terms of REDD+ as one of the cheaper and much more practical ways in terms of reducing and mitigating climate change. And that's certainly an issue that came up in our deliberations. The other aspect too, and very important, was how it is that we move the energy agenda forward and ensuring energy security and not having this sole dependence on fossil fuel in terms of also looking at supply. And a number of options were put on the table, as was stated in the joint statement. One was just in terms of support for renewable energy, alternative sources of energy, and efforts being undertaken by Guyana and other states. Take, for instance, our efforts in dealing with the issue of developing hydropower as well as other sources of renewable energy. And we certainly highlighted the need for continued support, especially by the U.S. in terms of voting at the IDB and other multilateral issues to support projects in Guyana as well across the region that will see us getting the necessary support to move our renewable energy agenda forward, because one, it's good for the economy, but also would help and deal with the issue, the global issue of climate change. And so there was that positive response also in dealing with that. There are many areas that we'll have to follow up, and there are a number of other meetings have been scheduled, both in terms of looking at the climate issues, but also dealing with looking at long-term support and the involvement of the private sector, greater coordination at the multilateral level in terms of supporting countries such as ours in dealing with our unique vulnerability in terms of ensuring energy and the steps that we are taking as we're doing with Amila and examining other projects. And so that certainly received the type of broad support, but certainly the follow-up efforts and ensuring that what countries such as ours and others within the region are doing will certainly receive support. We've seen, and as was presented, a number of other models where other countries are moving very aggressively. Some countries have been able to move within the region to have their non-fossil source of energy moving to about 80% alternative energy, whether it's geothermal, solar, wind, or hydro. Many countries have committed themselves to increasing, as it were, the percentage of power source coming from non-fossil, whether it's hydro, solar, wind, geothermal. And certainly that fits into Guyana and our government's policy. And so it was heartening to see that what we are doing nationally is in fact part of that wider strategic view for the region, and what the U.S. also wants to collaborate with countries in the U.S. in terms of partnership in developing and preparing us and ensuring that we have energy security. And I think that was a very important takeaway point, that we ourselves in Guyana, we are on track, and it certainly is consistent with what the region is doing and what the U.S. and a number of multilateral agencies were there, the World Bank, the IDB, the OAS itself, and there were also a number of financial opportunities and steps and commitments being taken to support strategic interventions that we're making to ensure energy security and also having a clean source as well as renewable source. And so the meeting itself was filled with possibilities, a lot of work to be done in moving this forward, and I'm quite sure the follow-up efforts and the leadership offered and the discussion certainly will allow us to move the region to a better level, a better position as it relates to energy security.